Hello, my name is Barry McCleary. Over the coming months, Megazyme will be producing training videos for a number of our methods. I hope that you find these videos are useful. The principle of the Seralpha alpha-amylase assay procedure is shown in this slide. The substrate is paranitrophenol blocked maltohepatose. This is prepared in the presence of a thermostable alpha-glucosidase, which has no action on the substrate because of the blocking group. When the substrate is hydrolyzed by alpha-amylase to produce blocked maltodextrin and paranitrophenol maltodextrin, the thermostable alpha-glucosidase immediately hydrolyzes the paranitrophenol maltodextrin, releasing free paranitrophenol. The reaction stopped by adding trisodium phosphate. This also develops the phenolate color. And this yellow color is then red on a spectrophotometer. As received, the Seralpha kit contains a booklet with the full assay method details, two vials of substrate, which is blocked paranitrophenol maltohepatose plus thermostable alpha-glucosidase, concentrated extraction buffer, concentrated stopping reagent, and a control malt flour. A control wheat flour is available on request. Seralpha reagent is a very sensitive assay reagent for alpha-amylase, so it's essential that the water used to make up the substrate is completely devoid of this activity. To do this, it's best to microwave the water first, bring it to boiling, then remove that from the microwave oven and place in ice to cool. This will ensure that any enzyme that may have been present in the water is inactivated. The Seralpha reagent is prepared by dissolving the contents of one of the vials in 10 mL of water that's been boiled and cooled to room temperature. The bottle's recapped, the contents are mixed thoroughly, and checking to make sure that all of the substrate has dissolved. This then is transferred to two polypropylene tubes for storage at minus 20 degrees centigrade between use. Extraction buffer array is prepared by diluting concentrated extraction buffer array to 1 liter with distilled water. This is transferred to a Durin bottle and stored at 4 degrees centigrade between use. Extraction buffer B is not supplied with the kit, but full instructions on how to prepare this buffer are given in the data booklet on page 4. Stopping reagent is prepared by diluting the concentrated solution supplied with the kit to 500 ml with distilled water. This solution is stable at room temperature for at least 3 months. Grain or malt samples are milled to pass a 0.5 mm screen using a Frisch or Resch centrifugal mill. After milling, the mill lid is removed. And the sample is transferred from the collection tray to a plastic bag. This is then transferred to a plastic storage container for convenience. To prepare malt extracts, first accurately weigh 0.5 grams of malt flour into a 100ml volumetric flask. Then remove the flask from the balance, tap it a few times to ensure that all the flour is transferred from the funnel into the flask. Malt flours are extracted with sodium chloride, calcium chloride extraction solution. This is poured into the volumetric flask. And it's made up to volume using a Pasteur pipette. And a bit more pouring. Cap the flask and mix well by inversion. This then will be left for 15 to 20 minutes at room temperature to allow complete extraction of the enzyme. Over this period of time, the flask is inverted and mixed a few times. After allowing the enzyme to extract for 15 to 20 minutes at room temperature, filter an aliquot of the solution through glass fiber filter paper. Alternatively, at this step, one can centrifuge the sample at about 1000 G for 10 minutes. Remove the filter funnels and then accurately transfer 0.5 mL of the filtrate to 9.5 mL of extraction buffer. Taking great care to transfer this solution accurately. Cap the tube and then mix thoroughly. Repeat this operation with sample 2. For ground wheat, barley and other grains, accurately weigh 3 grams of the flour into a 50ml beaker. Add 20ml of extraction buffer solution to the sample. Swirl the beaker, then cover with tin foil and place in a water bath at 40 degrees centigrade where it will be incubated for 15 to 20 minutes. Repeat this operation with the second sample. During this incubation period of 15 to 20 minutes, soluble starch in the sample is hydrolyzed by the alpha amylase that's present. Otherwise, this would act as a competitive substrate in the assay. During the 15 to 20 minute incubation period, occasionally remove the beakers from the water bath and swirl as shown. This will help enzyme extraction. Remove the beakers from the water bath and place onto absorbent paper. Remove the tinfoil covering. And then just mop up the water that's on the outside of the beaker so this doesn't run into the filter paper at the next step. Now filter the solution through glass fiber filter paper. Repeat this step with the second sample. Filtration takes approximately 5 minutes and the filtrate is used directly in the assay. For liquid microbial preparations, transfer 1 ml of the enzyme preparation to a 50 ml volumetric flask containing the extraction buffer, which may be either 5.4 or 6.5 depending on the alpha amylase being assayed. This transferring should be done with a positive displacement dispenser because the preparation is usually very viscous. Adjust the volume in the flask to 50 mL using the extraction buffer. Cap the flask, then mix very thoroughly. It's very important to be particular about this because the enzyme preparation is usually in glycerol or something similar and very viscous. So it's important to mix this extremely well. For powdered microbial preparations, add 1 gram of the preparation to 50 ml of the buffer, stir well to allow the enzyme to dissolve, and then filter the preparation for further dilution. Microbial preparations usually contain high concentrations of enzyme activity, so it's important to dilute this enzyme to get the enzyme activity on scale for the assay. This will be demonstrated now. First of all, the enzyme is transferred from the volumetric flask into a beaker. And then 0.5 ml of this solution is transferred to 4.5 ml of extraction dilution buffer, giving a 1 to 10 fold dilution. This is mixed thoroughly on a vortex mixer. This 10-fold dilution of the enzyme preparation is then diluted further by taking 0.55 ml of this solution and transferring to 4.5 ml of the buffer. This gives a 1 in 100 dilution. On transferring, the solution again is mixed very thoroughly on a vortex mixer. And this whole process of dilution of 0.5 ml of the enzyme or diluted enzyme into buffer is repeated up to 100,000 fold to ensure that the enzyme activity is on scale. Transfer 0.2 ml of substrate solution into the tubes to be used for assay. Have 2 tubes for each sample, plus 2 tubes for blanks. Put excess substrate back into the substrate container, cap, and place on ice. Put this rack of tubes then at 40 degrees centigrade and pre-incubate for 5 minutes. Also add the enzyme extracts as well.
To initiate the enzyme activity determination, transfer 0.2 ml of the sample extract to the pre-equilibrated substrate, being careful to transfer the enzyme to the bottom of the test tube to ensure that all of the enzyme comes in contact with the substrate. At the same time, start the stop clock, and after 15 seconds, add the duplicate amount of enzyme to the substrate. Again, to the bottom of the tube, stir the tube, place back in the water bath. Change the tip on the dispenser, and then take a sample of the second enzyme preparation. Add this to the substrate again. During all this process, be careful to keep an eye on the time clock, because the incubations in all cases must be exactly 10 minutes or 20 minutes, depending on the assay being performed. After the set incubation period of either 10 or 20 minutes, depending on the assay, add 3 ml of stopping reagent to the incubation tube to both stop the reaction and to develop the phenolate colour. Be careful to do this at the same time intervals at which the reactions are started. Then also add 3 ml of this stopping reagent to the blank solutions. And to these solutions, we'll also add 0.2 ml of acetate buffer so that the volume is exactly the same as the reaction mixtures. Addition of the stopping reagent both stops the reaction and develops the phenolate yellow colour. Here we can see the colours or reactions for sample 1, sample 2 and for the blank. The blank absorbance value will usually be less than 0.08. These colours are read on a spectrophotometer at 400 nanometers.
The method used for calculating alpha amylase activity is described on page 9 of the booklet. Basically, the absorbance is divided by incubation time, multiplied by the total volume in the reaction cell, divided by the aliquot acid, divided by the extinction coefficient of the paranitrophenol, then multiplied by the extraction volume, divided by sample weight, and multiplied by the dilution of the sample extract. The calculations for wheat and barley samples and for malt samples are shown in this slide. For wheat and barley, the activity is equivalent to the absorbance at 400 nanometers multiplied by 0.313. For malt, where there's much larger dilution involved, the activity is equivalent to the absorbance at 400 nanometers multiplied by 376. The calculations for microbial preparations are shown in this slide, where the dilution can vary from tenfold up to probably 10 or 100,000-fold. So the activity is equivalent to the absorbance at 400 nanometers multiplied by 4.7 multiplied by the dilution used for that particular sample. Calculation of alpha amylase activity can be simplified using the MegaCalc Excel calculation device is shown in this slide. Basically, data is entered into the yellow coloured boxes and the calculator calculates the specific activities. Just to get more information on how this calculator works, we'll look at the next slide. The specific details on how to use the calculator are summarised in this slide, where it shows where to enter sample details, the absorbance values to be added if you wish to change the sample volume, total volume, and it also shows how the basic calculation is done. The use of the MegaCalc calculator for measurement of alpha amylase in wheat samples is shown in this slide. First of all, the sample details are entered, then the blank absorbance values are entered into the top table. This is followed by the details of each individual sample and the absorbance values in duplicate obtained for those samples. The calculator automatically determines the average. Sample volume is changed if the actual value does change, otherwise it's left at 0.2 mL. The total volume in the assay cell is 3.4 mL. Incubation time is 20 minutes. If this is changed in the assay, change it in the calculator and it will automatically come into the calculations. The calculator then calculates alpha amylase activities at units per litre, and if the sample weight is included, which for wheat samples is 3 grams and extraction volume is 20 mils, the calculator will then automatically calculate units of activity per gram of sample.